Hello students, hope you're doing well. I, Dinesh Rawat, would be your faculty for the subject that is international business. And the topic for today's lecture would be introduction to international business. So in this lecture, we would be covering the definition of international business, few examples related to international business, and the drivers and a little bit about the evolution of international business. So what are the drivers of international business? So let's start. So first, you can see the references from where the PPT content has been made. So first is international book written by P.K. Sinha and Vivek Mittal. Then international business environment written by P. Subba Rao, a Marlin publication house. And third is the URL of our website. So from here, the data has been taken. So now we should start with the introduction part. So, coming to the definition of international business, first hum kuch examples ke saath discuss karte hain. So generally, ye examples hain related to the normal things or all the things which are present in our surrounding. So jaise aap dekh sakte hain, so the first example is the beverages you drink might be produced in India but with the collaboration of a US company. So jo bhi aap normally jaise beverages hain, cold drink hai aapka, Pepsi hai, Coca Cola hai, so they might be produced with the collaboration of a company that is in some other part of the world. So the tea you drink is prepared from the tea powder produced in Sri Lanka. It might be the spares and the hard disk of your computer you operate might have been produced in the United States of America. So the laptop which we use, so there is a the microprocessor chip that has been produced by some company that is not in India. So the perfume you apply might have been produced in France. The television you watch might have been produced with the Japanese technology, and the shoes which you are wearing, it might have been produced in Taiwan but remarketed by an Italian company. So it might happen also. So all these examples, these are the examples which we generally we can see around us. So there are a lot of products around us which are produced by companies that are not in India, so that are present outside India. So similarly, one more example is of internet. So generally, most of you must be using internet, and even some of you might have ordered something from the internet. So what happens, as you can see, most of you have experience of browsing internet and visiting different websites, and you knowing the products and services offered by various companies across the globe. And sometimes we even do not know where are these companies and what the products which we are saying are made by which companies and they are in which part of the world. So this process gives you the opportunity of transacting in the international business arena. So through internet you are able to transact or you are able to see all the products. So that is one of the example of international business arena. So all these activities have become a reality due to the operation and activities of international business. So jo bhi hum internet pe dekh rahe hain products एंड जो भी हम प्रोडक्ट को बाय कर रहे हैं या हम कुछ भी ऑर्डर करते हैं और हमें डिलीवर हो जाता है, दैट हैज बीन इट हैज बीन पॉसिबल ड्यू टू द ऑपरेशन एंड एक्टिविटीज ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. सो नाउ कमिंग टू द डेफिनेशंस, सो द नॉर्मल डेफिनेशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस इज द इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस एनकंपासेस अ फुल रेंज ऑफ क्रॉस बॉर्डर एक्सचेंजेस ऑफ गुड्स सर्विसेज रिसोर्सेज बिटवीन टू और मोर नेशंस. These exchanges can go beyond the exchange of money. So isme bas exchange of money for physical goods hi nahi hota hai, there are other resources also, such as people, intellectual property, such as patents, copyrights, brand trademarks, contractual assets and liabilities. So apart from physical good, the exchange of physical good, there are a lot of things apart from the exchange of physical good, like people, intellectual property, contractual assets and liabilities. International business relate to any situation where production or distribution of goods and services crosses country borders. So that is the definition of international business. जैसे आप एक्सपोर्ट है, उसके बाद नए नए टर्म्स आजकल हम देखते हैं जैसे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. सो दीज आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. देन व्हाई इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस? सो दीज आर फ्यू यू नो रीजंस व्हिच वुड हेल्प यू व्हाई कंपनीज गो फॉर इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. सो लिमिटेड होम मार्केट, ऑब्वियसली जब आपका जो डोमेस्टिक मार्केट है जब वो आपको लिमिटेड होता है तो देन इन ऑर्डर टू इंक्रीज योर सेल्स सो यू गो फॉर इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. सो व्हेन द साइज ऑफ द होम मार्केट इज लिमिटेड आइदर ड्यू टू द स्मॉलर साइज ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन और ड्यू टू द लो परचेजिंग पावर ऑफ द पीपल और बोथ, द कंपनीज इंटरनेशनलाइज देयर ऑपरेशन. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल मोस्ट ऑफ द जैपनीज ऑटोमोबाइल कंपनीज जो हैं एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फर्म्स एंटर्ड इनटू यूएस, यूरोप एंड इवन अफ्रीकन मार्केट्स ड्यू टू द स्मॉलर साइज ऑफ द होम मार्केट. देन यू हैव अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड कॉम्पोनेंट ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज. ऑब्वियसली जहां पर आपको टेक्नोलॉजी अच्छी मिलेगी या फिर ह्यूमन रिसोर्स अच्छा मिलेगा सो कंपनी प्रेफर करेंगी उस कंट्री में जाके बिजनेस करने के लिए. सो अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड कॉम्पोनेंट ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज, कॉम्पिटेंट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स इन सम कंट्रीज एक्ट एज अ पुलिंग फैक्टर्स फॉर बिजनेस फर्म्स फ्रॉम होम कंट्री. नेक्स्ट इज इवोल्यूशन. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट कैसे इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस इवॉल्व हुआ है and what are the different institutions which has helped in the evolution of international business. So first hum dekh sakte hain world war 1 ke baad generally jo countries thi unhone bahut sare trade barriers, the barriers to trade wo start kar diye the lagana, to jiski wajah se bahut sari countries ko suffer hua aur unka trade jo tha international trade wo itna boom nahi ho paya. So as you can see, after World War First, various governments initiated and imposed a number of barriers to trade to protect their domestic production. Ultimate purpose tha unka domestic production ko protect karne ke liye. So advanced countries experience setback consequent up on the imposition of such trade barriers. So in trade barriers ki wajah se bahut sari countries ko suffer karna pada. Then the country nation felt for the need of international cooperation. So कंट्रीज ने डिसाइड करा यस ये जो हमारा इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड है ये कम हो रहा है, सो देयर इज अ नीड फॉर इंटरनेशनल कोऑपरेशन एंड दिस नीड लेड टू और जो उनके एफर्ट्स थे द रिजल्टेड इन द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ आईएमएफ एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक. वर्ल्ड बैंक दैट इज इंटरनेशनल बैंक फॉर रिकंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डेवलपमेंट. सो ये दो इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं जो सेटअप हुए इन ऑर्डर टू हेल्प द इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड. So IMF इसको हम डिटेल में डिस्कस करेंगे कमिंग लेक्चर्स में एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक. सो नाउ दीज टू इंस्टीट्यूशन दे प्लेड एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. सो दिस इज अ स्क्रीनशॉट फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट ऑफ IMF. सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू विजिट IMF वेबसाइट एंड सी वॉट आर देयर ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. So as you can see, IMF is an organization of 189 countries working to foster global monetary cooperation, secure financial stability, and facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and reduce poverty. So these are some of the objectives of IMF. Now World Bank, this is a screenshot from the website of World Bank. So you should visit World Bank website also, and then you know if you want any kind of data related to any company, let it be export data or you want GDP data, so you can get it from the World Bank website. So the World Bank is a vital source of financial and technical assistance to developing countries around the world. Established in 1944, the World Bank Group is headquartered in Washington DC. So these are the two institutions. Now after that, along with this, there is one more important institution, that is World Trade Organization. So which was set up in 1995. So what happened? World War One ke baad, then World War Two hua. Uske baad situation, you know, or aapka situation improve hone ki wajah se improve situation nahi ho paya. So it was felt consequently 23 countries conducted negotiation in 1947 in order to prevent the protectionism policies and to revive economies from recession. So international trade organization jo unhone set up kara, then the attempt of the advanced countries ended with GATT, that is General Agreement on Trade and Tariff, and finally 1995 first January ko jo GATT unhone form kara tha usko convert kar diya World Trade Organization mein. So this is the third institution. First was your World Bank, then IMF, and now World Trade Organization. So these three institutions played an important role in the evolution of international business. This is a screenshot from the website of WTO. So as you can see, the WTO is the only global international organization dealing with the rules of trade between nations. So ab India hai, that is also a member, 1995 se one of the starting members of WTO, and China is also a member of WTO. So abhi jaise jo issue hai, that is boycott of Chinese product. So it is not easy for Indian government to all of a sudden to boycott the Chinese product. Since both of them are members of WTO, so they have to follow the rules of WTO. So you all must visit the website of WTO. There are various reports which are issued by WTO and which can be helpful for further studies. So we can see the efforts of all three institutions, that is IMF, World Bank, and WTO, along with the efforts of individual country, led to the globalization of business. So finally, international trade started increasing due to the efforts of these institutions. Now the international trade led to the international marketing. So what happened, as you can see, originally the producer used to export their products to the nearby countries and gradually extended the export to far off countries. So jaise India se pehle Nepal agar ja raha hai, to now India se wo Nepal ke sath sath aur bhi further jo far off countries hai wahan bhi export jane laga. For example, India used to export raw cotton, raw jute, iron ore during early 1900. The massive industrialization in the country enabled us to export rather than jo normal raw cotton bechte the, raw jute bechte the, ab wo products bechne lag gaye. So jute ke products, cotton, garments, steel during 1960. So 1900 tak raw form mein jata tha. Uske baad after industrialization 1960s mein उनके प्रोडक्ट्स जाने लगे, जैसे जूट प्रोडक्ट्स, कॉटन गारमेंट, स्टील. एंड ड्यूरिंग 1990s एक फर्दर इम्प्रूवमेंट हुआ. रादर देन जस्ट एक्सपोर्टिंग, एक्सपोर्ट करने के साथ साथ द एम्फेसिस वाज ऑन दैट इज एक्सपोर्ट मार्केटिंग एफर्ट्स इंक्लूड क्रिएशन ऑफ डिमांड फॉर इंडियन प्रोडक्ट्स, अरेंजिंग फॉर अप्रोप्रिएट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल्स, अट्रैक्टिव पैकेज, प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट एंड प्राइसिंग. सो there is a improvement. 1900 mein normal raw form mein jaate the, uske baad after industrialization uske raw form ki wajah se uske products jaane lag gaye. And 1980s mein exporting ke sath sath the focus was on marketing also. So distribution channels kya hone chahiye, attractive pricing, packaging kya honi chahiye, so the focus on distribution also. So we can say international trade converted into international marketing. And finally, international marketing was converted into international business. So jo MNC companies hoti hain, jo MNC multinational companies thi, which were producing the products in their home countries and marketing them in various foreign countries before 1980s, they starting locating their plants and other manufacturing facilities in the host country. So now जो MNCs अपनी कंट्री से इंडिया में एक्सपोर्ट कर रही थी, उन्होंने अपने प्लांट सेटअप करने लगे इंडिया में. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यूनिलीवर एस्टेब्लिश सब्सिडरी कंपनी इन इंडिया, हिंदुस्तान लीवर लिमिटेड, एंड HHL ने प्रोड्यूसेस इट्स प्रोडक्ट्स इन इंडिया एंड दे स्टार्टेड मार्केटिंग देयर प्रोडक्ट्स इन बांग्लादेश, श्रीलंका एंड नेपाल. सो HHL they set up their plants in India and jo products yahan banate the India mein, apart from India they also started selling those products in other countries. So the scope of international trade is expanded into international marketing, and the scope of international marketing is expanded to international business. So this is all about the evolution of international business. Now the last part of this lecture is the drivers of international business. कौन से वो ड्राइवर्स थे जिन्होंने प्रमोट करा इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस को. तो जैसे मैंने कहा है, तीन इंस्टीट्यूशन जो हम डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे इन कमिंग लेक्चर्स में, वर्ल्ड बैंक, IMF एंड WTO. सो ये तीन, तो इन तीनों इंस्टीट्यूशन ने बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करा है इन द इंक्रीज ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. सो फर्स्ट WTO, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, 1995 में इट केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस. Then you have regional integration. So regional integration is, so let's suppose Asia mein jitni countries hai, if they come together and they form a committee or they form a group, that kind of group is called, is an example of regional integration. So few of the example are European Union, jo European, Europe ki sari countries hai, so unko hum club kar dete hai, then it becomes a European Union. Then NAFTA is there, so North America Free Trade Agreement, and then ASEAN. So regional integration, the regional and economic integration of countries of the same region and areas increases the size of the market, aggregate demands for products and services, and quantity of production, employment, ultimately the economic activity of the region. So this is called regional integration. So first is one of the example of regional integration would be European Union. So as you can see, the European Economic Community is also known as European Common Market. So originally 6 countries, they came up and they formed European Economic Community by Treaty of Rome 1957, and the number of member increased from 6 to 15 by 2004, and the EAC by enlarging its scope and operation turned into European Union. So European Union mein there is a common agriculture policy. Jo bhi country hai sari, jo number of countries hai, they all follow a common agriculture policy, common monetary policy, and common fishery policy. And EU has emerged as one of the market from one of the largest market from January 2002. And with the introduction of common currency, isme ek hi currency follow karte hain sari countries, that is Euro. Next is NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement. So isme USA, Canada, and Mexico, ye tino countries hai. So inke beech mein there is a free trade agreement. So I would request you to see the news related to NAFTA. Since abhi jaise Donald Trump jo hai, that is, he is against NAFTA. So he is proposing a new agreement, that is USMCA, United States, Mexico, Canada agreement. So this is a new agreement which is proposed by Donald Trump. So you should see the news related to NAFTA. So the NAFTA is one of the example of regional integration which has played an important role, or which is an important driver of international business. So the one more driver, important driver, is foreign direct investment. So the growth in foreign direct investment is also one of the important factors which has led to international business. So the investment made by a company in new manufacturing or marketing facility in a foreign country is referred to as foreign direct investment. There are a number of reasons for the growth of FDI in recent years. So the reasons include increase in sales and profit, obviously, enter rapidly growing market, reduce cost, consolidated trade blocks, protect domestic market, protect foreign markets, acquire technology and managerial know-how. So these are some of the reasons why FDI is encouraged. And the last is the in the drivers of international business, that is the strides in technology. So internet ne bahut ek important role play kara hai in the growth of international business. Internet ki help se you are able to see those companies jinke bare mein hame pata nahi hai, those products which are made by companies. And वो किस कंट्री में, ये भी हमें नहीं पता है, बट स्टिल थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ इंटरनेट और वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब वी आर एबल टू एक्सेस दोस प्रोडक्ट्स एंड कंपनीज. सो फाइनली दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. सो इसमें हमने डेफिनेशंस अलोंग विद एग्जांपल्स आप एक्सप्लेन करते हैं, देन इवोल्यूशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस, कैसे 1900 में क्या होता था, आफ्टर इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन द फोकस वॉज ऑन rather than exporting, marketing mein bhi ek focus ho gaya. So international trade se international marketing ho gayi, and then MNCs ne apne plants host country mein set up karne lage, so that becomes your international business. So international marketing se international business ho gaya. Then the drivers, so apart from the IMF, World Bank and WTO, there are other drivers of international business like FDI is there, internet, world wide web. So these are the drivers of international business. So after this, after, you know, once you through with this video, from you are required to visit World Bank website, and you are required to report exports of goods and services. First aap dekhenge in the percentage of GDP, then in US dollar mein, दो वर्ल्ड के एंड इंडिया के फ्रॉम 2014 टू 2020। सो आपको 2014 से 2020 तक आप नोट करेंगे, क्या नोट करेंगे, एक्सपोर्ट्स ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज। कहाँ पर जाके, वर्ल्ड बैंक वेबसाइट में आप एक्सपोर्ट्स पे क्लिक करेंगे एंड देन यू वुड सी वर्ल्ड के ओवरऑल वर्ल्ड का कितना एक्सपोर्ट रहा है 2014 से 20 तक, दो सिनेरियो में, एक तो परसेंटेज ऑफ जीडीपी एंड दूसरा यूएस डॉलर में। और सिमिलरली आप इंडिया के लिए करेंगे। एंड आफ्टर दिस क्लास यू विल रिसीव अ गूगल फॉर्म लिंक, सो बाई इवनिंग यू कैन कंप्लीट द असाइनमेंट एंड यू कैन अपलोड योर असाइनमेंट शीट थ्रू दैट गूगल फॉर्म लिंक। सो दैट इज ऑल फॉर टुडे। थैंक यू सो मच।